here in Sydney in Hyde Park, we have this memorial. It's a World War I and World War II memorial. Around the base, we have these circular shapes. There are four of them representing the four elements, the four directions, and the four seasons. This is where the spirit orbs would lie around here. And then we have the stonework here, representing there would be seven layers of this going in, I would suggest, esoterically. Representing the edifice of a magic ritual space, we have the pillars, which are pillars of light, and we have the tower structure, the watchtower structure in the center, I would suggest. This also dovetails as the guardian spirit in the center. So now we will go to Liverpool in Sydney, and we will have a look at some further structures in Liverpool. Here on Macquarie Street in Liverpool, we have a statue of Freemason and ex-governor, and now deceased, Lachlan Macquarie, standing on a pyramid right there, and he is emanating out of the pyramid, if you will. So let's have a closer look at it. I would suggest that the space right here represents the ritual space, with the lights around here representative of the four directions, the four seasons, earth, air, fire and water, etc. And we have the sort of rings going into the center of the ritual space, with the pyramidal edifice, and then in this case Mr. Macquarie emanating out. Up in here we have the plumb bowl just here, the level, feather, various items of industry and items that are relevant to Freemasonry. Again, in the other side, there's interestingly, there's a telescope there, and so forth. So what we'll do now is head down Macquarie Street here, and we'll have a look at some things as we go down. Further down the street, we have this, at this crossing here, we have this Aboriginal design that was put in by a smoking ceremony. And if we cross the street here, we have these Greek designs, the Delta, the Pi Phi, I think it is, and Omega, just here with the, of course, the checkered pattern coming through here. Coming further down the street here, and just about to cross, it's a bit like a river crossing just here at this junction, and we'll keep on heading up. The rounded sections here, in this case with the three steps going up, possibly relate to the chakras heading down here as we head down further. We have a round sort of a theatre section up here. As we progress up the street here, we have these four plaques, and we have a pillar on one side and a pillar, if you will, on the other side too, a stylized version here, a stylized plaque of Governor Lachlan Macquarie coming out of that pyramid, if you will, emanating out of that, what I would suggest is kind of a ritual situation. Further up the street here, we have this monument with the four sort of circular regions around it. I would suggest that they are representative of the outer part of the edifice of a magic ritual, with this character here with the heart litten up, like the heart chakra litten up, if you will. And it, to me, it has a bit of a green tinge to it. Interestingly, from the back of the sculpture, the actual heart has a green colour to it, right in the centre there, along with the blue and greyish colour in there. We have what are perhaps representations of spirit energies and spirits within the ritual area here. There are various Fibonacci spirals about also, if we have a look around. And right in the center, we have the bull, the Taurian bull, the bull of St. Luke. We have another heart here on the back, interestingly, of this character, as if you can see through the character. We have the snake on the pole, the representation of the dollar sign, and once again the eye with the crown. And again on this pentagram type star, we have the what could perhaps be the Fibonacci spiral. We have reference perhaps to the checkered floor in the center here also, and some interesting iconography within the center. So I would suggest that even though this looks very sort of childlike and playful and all the rest of it, it once again is a representative of the edifice of a magic ritual space, with your center column and then your outer spirits, positions for the spirits amidst certain part of the ritual, where you have earth, water, air and fire, the four directions, the four seasons, etc. So we'll keep progressing up. Within the kids' playground here, just up from the from what I would suggest is the edifice of a magic ritual, we have reference here to the seasons, the four seasons around here, and the four directions. And of course, these would relate also to earth, wind, air, and fire, the four main elements. After the playground, we have the games of chess going on here. And if I turn around, we have the larger chess board right here with a game of chess being played right now. So again, and we'll keep moving up. Just over to the left over here is the church, St. Luke's Church. So we'll move up and have a look at these pillars just here. So with the game of chess happening over here, we have the pillars, and we have, it's like a semicircle here mainly. So we have say 9 o'clock, you could say 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock right here. In the center, we would have the sun motif, here. They've even taken the trouble to put lights in here where the rays of light, where the light would come out of the rays of the sun. Interestingly here, and nearer to the center, you could perhaps think of this as the 6 o'clock pillar. It's broken, a broken pillar, which is very, a broken pillar of light, I would suggest, within the edifice of a ritual. And of course, we see this iconography within Freemasonry. We have these four stones, ashlars, with rough and smooth surfaces on them. The four of them perhaps representing the elements, the seasons, the directions, etc. And we have various symbolism on the pillars. So if we have a closer look at some of that, so this is to do, this is a war memorial here, so various things to do with war. But I'll just point out a few bits and pieces. Here we have the crossing iconography here, which I would suggest is representative of the meeting of male and female, the meeting of sort of black and white, the opposite forces within a magic ritual. Interestingly, within this bell type recess here, we have this the kind of pyramidal structure with the area of equilibrium in the middle with male and female. Elsewhere we can see within the iconography the serpent on a pole within the military iconography, and the wheat also the wheat symbolic of springtime and of Aries. On Australia we have the winged disc, for example. Also with the pillars, we have two types of pillars here, two main types. So we have the stone pillars, and then we have the pillars, which are in this case the cages with plants in them, but they would all sort of represent the same thing, all sort of represent light within a magic ritual, I would suggest. So these are indicative of the non sort of the non materialistic nature of pillars, I would suggest. And within the negative spaces going around, there would be 12 in a full circle, if this was a full circle. So we would have a representation of the full zodiac with the sun in the center. So further up here, within Westfields, we can see what within this within the architecture, we can see what are perhaps sort of wheels within wheels. This iconography, which I find interesting, there are also the sort of little circles there too around here, which perhaps are represent sort of spirits as well, perhaps. And on the floor in here, there's some interesting iconography. In St. Luke's Church, within the grounds here, there's this garden, and within the garden is a winged bull, a winged Taurian bull, if you will, the bull of St. Luke, the winged bull of St. Luke. Here it is in the center here, right in the center of this round garden. So if we have a look at the plaque, we can learn some more about it off the plaque. So just reading through, these gardens were created by the Liverpool City Council, assisted by the Rotary Club. Now the Rotary Club is tied with Freemasonry of Liverpool, on land leased from the parish to commemorate the 150th anniversary of the completion of the church, and were unveiled on the 19th of July 1969 by His Worship the Mayor, Alderman G. Pacciolo. Reading down further here, the central garden is in the form of the crest from the Liverpool City coat of arms, with a castellating stone wall in the shape of a crown symbolising a stronghold and corporate town. The crosslet, interesting corporate town, the crosslet in the grassy mound represents the founding of the church by the Governor Macquarie, in whose arms such a cross appears. The sculpture is the winged bull of St. Luke, carved in Appin sandstone by May Barry. Just reading down further then, the church is a fine example of colonial architecture in the Georgian tradition, and was commissioned by Governor Macquarie in 1817, designed by Francis Greenway, a very famous designer, Francis Greenway, a Freemason. It was built by Nathaniel Lucas and James Smith for £1,750 using convict labour. The first service was held on St. Luke's Day, the 18th of October 1819, with the Reverend Robin Cartwright being the first rector. So there you go. So with this commemorative garden here in the grounds of St. Luke's Church, with the bull in the center, the energies, the Taurian energies, if you will, of the bull in the center. We have that, of course, in the center of the town, and you can actually see that sculpture, part of the sculpture in the town center from here. So I would suggest, and we have the crown here, it's the outer part is representative of the crown, so I would suggest that this is a representation of a magic ritual edifice. It's interesting to have the cross in the center of what I would suggest is the ritual edifice, the magic ritual edifice. The cross in the center, the cross of light, I would suggest, and of course the cross sort of branches off, if you will.